I know the title sounds bad, but before I explain myself, you guys got some serious explaining to do. You see, if I scroll through my channel and I go to the viewers also watch section, why does this come up? Explain this to me, guys. Why does this come up? Come on, boys, we cannot be this down bad. But let's get back to the actual story today. Before I even say anything, I need everyone to know I am not EDP445. Okay, I in no way, shape, or form encouraged this, wanted this to happen, or anything like that. This fifth grade girl literally stole my phone number from my mom's phone, texted me, and tried to hook up with me. Okay, okay, I know it sounds ridiculous, but just let me explain, okay? Bro, why do I feel like I'm on trial right now and I'm in a courtroom and I'm about to be locked up? It's not like that, bro, I swear, okay? So, my mom's a fifth grade teacher, right? And once a year, I always go to her classroom to meet her kids and all that stuff. And you know, being like 18 at the time and a college athlete, these kids basically thought I was the second coming of Jesus Christ.
And here come the comments.
How dare you use the Lord's name in vain? Don't say Jesus Christ. Bro, just stop. Please just stop. I use my own mother's name in vain, okay? I just said my mother is a teacher. Who the fuck wants to be a teacher? Like, why would you make it your life mission to become a teacher? Like, why the fuck would you make it your life mission to become a teacher who can barely afford rent on like a fucking apartment that fits like two people max? It's for the kids though. I love helping the kids. Fuck the kids. I don't know, man. I just have a really strong hatred for teachers. I just feel like they're all losers, my mom included. Just kidding. Well, sort of. Okay, but anyways, usually I go to my mom's school like once a year, and you know, usually I play like soccer and basketball, and my mom's a fifth grade teacher, and so usually when I go there, all the fifth grade girls are like, oh my god, he's so cute. And listen, it's not because I'm like Leonardo DiCaprio or anything like that, okay? The only reason they say that is because I'm like 10 years older than them and I can run fast. I mean, back in elementary school, whoever was the most athletic got all the girls. That's the only thing that even mattered. And me being like 10 years older than these fifth graders, I could just fucking stomp on these kids and practically just jump over them. I mean, I literally jumped over them when I played basketball. So usually when I go there, I'm used to some of the girls being like, he's so cute. But this one year when I went was different than all of the others. Like, it got uncomfortable. So this one year I go to my mom's school, and before I even went there, you know, my mom would talk to the kids about like who I am, what I do and all that shit. And she would tell the kids like all my accomplishments and all the races I had, because I did like cross country and track in high school, and now I'm doing it in college as Division I athlete. Not trying to flex, I'm just trying to give people who don't know context, okay? Don't fucking come at me in the comments. And my mom, like any parent, likes to brag about my accomplishments and shit, and she would always show like my high school race videos to the kids. And when she would show the kids these race videos, there was always this one girl that was like, oh my god, he's so hot. And this girl would constantly be asking my mom about me. She would ask my mom shit like, does he have a girlfriend? What kind of sports does he like? Do you think he'll like me? You know how girls are back then. All of them are like, one day I'm gonna date all of the boys in the One Direction band. Like, all of them seriously believe that they have a shot with like a 20-year-old celebrity. So if those girls think that they have a shot with someone in One Direction, this girl definitely thought she had a serious chance with me, okay? And besides this one girl watching my race videos, there was always this other fifth grade guy that would watch my race videos and be like, you know what? I think I could take him. Like, he would always go up to my mom and be like, if me and your son race, I'd 100% beat him. You see, he was the fastest kid in his elementary school, so he thought that that meant he was the fastest in the world. And he seriously believed in all of his bones that he could seriously take me in a race. And so I go to my mom's school, and before I even had the chance to say hi to the kids or anything like that and like introduce myself, the kid who always tells my mom that he would beat me in a race comes up to me and goes, we're racing right now. Come on, let's go. Let's do it. And I already told you, my mom told me about this kid, so I knew he really wanted to race me really badly. So I looked at the kid and I was like, okay, we'll race in a second. Just let me say hi to everyone. You know what I mean? Like, I was just trying to be nice to everyone before. And then, of course, I'll race this kid. Was I gonna smoke him? 100%. But yeah, I was gonna race this kid. This kid took that as an offense. This little fifth grade kid had the balls to look at me and go, what, you scared, bro? And then all of a sudden, two of his homies come out from literally nowhere, stand behind them and have their arms crossed looking at me and go, yeah, you scared, bro? And I'm standing here like, am I about to get jumped by three fifth graders? What the fuck is going on? All of these kids had their arm crossed looking at me like they're about to shank me or something. But I looked at the kid and I was like, I'll race you. Just let me say hi to all the other kids, okay? And so I go over to the rest of the class and I'm saying hi to everyone. And I go over to the girl that always says, oh my god, he's so hot. I didn't know what this girl looked like, but I could just tell it was her by the way she was looking at me. I mean, she was looking at me like I was fucking Justin Bieber or some shit. And she comes up to me, and before I could even say like hello to her or anything, the first thing she says to me is, you have to beat him in the race. You have to. And I'm standing there like, why the fuck is everyone talking about this? Why is this race so important to everyone? Turns out, by the information I gathered from the rest of the class, that half of the class class was betting that I was gonna win this race, and the other half of the class actually thought and was betting that this fifth grader was gonna beat me in a race. And the two different sides of the class that were betting on this race literally have not talked to each other in like a week. Like, this was some serious shit. Like, for some reason, these little kids were treating this race that I didn't even know I was being a part of until like 5 minutes ago like it was a fucking war. And as I'm talking to this girl, I look over to my right, and the kid who literally 5 seconds ago just said, "What, you scared, bro?" is running up and down the basketball court, staring directly at me and yelling to me and saying, "Yeah, you see this? You see how fast I'm going right now? Yeah, you better be scared." And I'm sitting here like, what the fuck is going on? Is this kid trying to fight me or race me? I cannot believe this little fifth grader is actually talking shit to me while I'm just trying to say hi to the rest of his class. And so the girl that I'm talking to looks at me and goes, "He's been talking so much trash about you. You have to beat him. You have to beat him for me." Okay, there is so much going on in my mind right now. First off, why is this kid trash talking me? Bro, I just got here like 5 minutes ago. I don't even know you. Why do you want to race me so bad? Okay, second off, why is there like a fucking civil war going on right now? It got to the level of like Bloods and Crips. Like, they would not talk to each other. They would not look at each other like nothing, bro. I don't know why this shit is so serious right now and why the school is taking this shit so seriously right now. Third off, and most importantly, did this little fifth grader really just say, "You have to win this race for me"? I'm not trying to catch a case, bro. I'm not trying to end up like EDP, okay? So I look at the girl and I kind of just laugh it off and I'm like, "Ha ha ha, win the race for you. Ha ha ha, yeah, ha ha ha." Because I couldn't just tell this girl that I wasn't doing this race for her and make her cry and depressed and be like, "I'm not doing this race for you. Go fuck yourself." Like, I didn't want to make this girl cry and depressed, okay? Like, you know, she had like a little elementary school crush on me, you know? So I was trying to be like kind of nice, you know what I mean? And so I get back to saying hi to everyone in the whole class. And then all of a sudden, like 15 fifth grade guys come up to me and are like, "It's time. You said hi to everyone. It's time to race." What the hell is going on? Like, my mom did not inform me that this shit was so serious, okay? And here's the thing about me, right? I'm a very competitive person. Like, I don't give a fuck how old you are, who you are, what you do. I don't care. If we play in something, it could literally be like rock, paper, scissors. I'm gonna take that shit seriously. And I'm gonna try my ass off to beat you. Bro, on a side note, that's why I can't have kids. Like, I'm not gonna be able to play like basketball or like baseball with my kid. Like, my kid's gonna be like, "Daddy, let's play basketball." And I'm gonna be like fucking dunking on him and like posting him up and like trucking him and just sending him to the fucking floor. Like, I'm not gonna be able to contain myself. Like, my kid ain't getting no easy buckets on me, okay? I'm blocking him. I'm sending that ball to Mars. I don't care. So when these kids come up to me and this one kid really thinks that he can beat me in a race and has been talking trash about me to all of his homies, I'm about to put this fifth grader in his place. I don't care if he's like 8. This fifth grader needs to be put in his place. And so I go over to race this kid and we get to where we're gonna race. And this little fifth grader actually has the audacity to look at me and say, "So, what head start do you want me to give you? You want me to give you like a 5 second head start or like a 10 second head start? Like, what do you want, bro?" Bro, no way this fifth grader just said that to me. Listen, I was already gonna beat this kid and I already in my mind was gonna beat this kid 100% and just humiliate him. But now I need to end his entire running career, his life. Like, there's no way that this fifth grader can say that to me when I'm a Division I track athlete. Look, should I have gotten this mad over a fifth grader just being a fifth grader? No. But like, I ain't gonna let someone say that to me. I don't care how old he is. I don't care if he's 8. Oh, just let the kid win. Come on, be a nice person. Fuck that kid. That kid needs to be put in his place. So the race starts and it was like a 100 meter race. And if you don't know what a 100 meter race is, it's basically like one section of the track. If you don't get that, I'm not gonna explain it. Anyways, it's a short race, okay? And as soon as the race started, I didn't even start running. I immediately just turned around and started running backwards. And I just smoked this kid running backwards. I mean, to the point where it was like Usain Bolt against like a turtle. And listen, I don't care if you judge me right now, but it was the greatest feeling running backwards and being able to see this kid's face change from absolute confidence to realizing he had no chance with me. You could see him realize right then in that moment, "Wow, I'm just a bitch ass fifth grader." And it was just a great feeling. Like, yes, I know I'm a fucked up person, okay? Like, I'm willing to admit that ruining fifth graders' dreams does give me joy and happiness, okay? And I don't care. But as soon as I crossed the finish line, I got hit with a very sudden realization that this girl is gonna think that I just won the race for her. This is not good. Like, I could literally see her face as I crossed the line, and you could just tell that this girl thought, "Oh my god, he did it for me." And like, yeah, it was like a harmless elementary school crush that this girl has on me, but being like an 18-year-old and having a little kid think you're hot is just weird and uncomfortable, okay? Like, I know some people are like, "Oh my god, it's so cute that this girl had a little crush on you. Nah, bro, that's not cute. I could technically be like her dad, okay? And so a couple minutes after the race finished, these group of girls come up to me. And these group of girls ask me, and they're like, is it true you won the race for her? And before I can even say anything, one of the other girls goes, that's so romantic. And I'm like, what the fuck? Like, I already thought this was weird, but now this is getting really weird, okay? And so I tell the girls, and I'm like, nah, I didn't win the race for anyone. I just raced for me. And then one of the girls looks at me and goes, sure you did. I can see the way you look at her. You don't need to tell me twice. What do you mean the way I looked at her? I just met her like 10 minutes ago. I've looked at her like twice. What are these girls talking about? So after these girls said that, I decided for my freedom and not wanting to get locked up behind bars that for the rest of the day, I'm not going to talk to this girl. I'm not going to look at this girl. I'm not going to be anywhere near this girl. And it worked. The whole rest of the day went fine. I completely forgot about the situation and she was never really brought up the whole rest of the day. Now this is where things get weird. I wake up the next morning and I check my phone and I got a text from a number I didn't know. And the text said, hey, it's Isabella. And I was lying in bed like, who the fuck is Isabella? And I started thinking about like all the girls in my school and my classes. And I was like, there's not a single Isabella in my school or that I know of. And so I text back and I'm like, Isabella who? And I get a text back in literally 30 seconds and the text says, Isabella from yesterday, silly. Now I'm thinking, I'm like, who did I see yesterday? I didn't see anyone from my school yesterday. The only people that I saw were from the kids in my mom's school. Oh my god, it all started clicking. The girl texting me was the girl from my mom's school. I didn't even know her name. How does she have my number? And I'm laying in bed confused and scared, wondering how this little girl got my number, when all of a sudden I get another text from Isabella saying, you did really good in that race for me yesterday. Listen, that was it for me, okay? I ain't gonna get caught in a parking lot trying to look for some cupcakes, okay? R.I.P. EDP. And I immediately just blocked her number. I was like, I'm done with this. And I wanted to just be done with this, but I couldn't just be done with this yet. See, I was way too curious and I needed to know how this fifth grade girl got my number. And so I told my mom and I was like, mom, one of your students somehow is texting me. And so my mom goes to school the next day and basically interrogates this girl and finds out that somehow this fifth grade girl got a hold of my mom's phone, scrolled through my mom's contacts until she found my number and added it to her phone. Honestly, bro, respect. That's some like 007 shit. But I was thinking about this and I was like, oh my god, this girl thought she had so much of a chance with me that she was willing to risk going through her own teacher's phone just to get my number. She really thought she was going places with a freshman in college. That's how much confidence she had in herself. And I was sitting here like, damn, am I really that bad to the point where a fifth grader thinks that she has a chance with me? Like, am I really in the same league as a fifth grader? And not even like a cute fifth grader. Like, I at least want to be in the same league as like a cute fifth grader. You know what I mean? That's a joke. FBI, do not come for me, please. FBI, that's a joke. And I mean, nothing really happened after that. Well, yeah, that's how a fifth grader stole my phone number. Wait. Hold up. What is going on? As I'm recording this video, I just checked my TikTok and it says I have a total of 0 followers. Bro, I just wanted to check my TikTok because I wanted to know if I was at 200K. Like, I was only a couple hundred away and now I'm going on TikTok and I have 0 followers. Well, at least I have the same number of followers as Charli D'Amelio now. Well, hopefully by the time this publishes, I have my followers back. But if not, go follow my TikTok. You literally may be my first follower. All right, guys, that's going to be it for today's video though. Thanks for watching. Please subscribe if you're not already subscribed and I'll see you guys in the next one. Peace.